Welcome to The Critics. It's our third edition, and this time we're taking a look at the hits and misses of the summer 2012 movie season. I'm Jackson Murphy of lights-camera-jackson.com and YNN, and joining me once again are Amy Biancoli of the Hearst Newspapers and RottenTomatoes.com, and Jim Dixon, the National Fanboys Examiner and Capital District Movies Examiner on Examiner.com. Welcome back, guys.
Thanks for having us, Jackson.
Thank you very much. All right, we're going to start off with the favorite action movies of the summer. Jim, what were some of your favorites?
We had three good superhero movies, right, all with good action and good property damage. I'm going to go for Dark Knight Rises as having the best. And I'm going to throw in Premium Rush, which just opened. I think the bike sequences in that movie are mind-blowing and a little bit different than the typical machine guns and gasoline explosions that are dotting most of the Hollywood.
There's a lot of action in that movie. It's all on a bike, but there is a lot of action.
I enjoyed those chase sequences.
And some of them are really hairy.
Yeah.
And Dark Knight Rises, I liked it. I didn't love it. I didn't think it was extraordinary. I know you have a different opinion.
I didn't like it or love it. Or rather, I didn't love it or like it. I would go down one more step and say I actively disliked it. So
really?
I know I'm in the minority, but I found it ponderous and messy and with a terribly weak villain I couldn't understand.
Didn't love the opening scene involving Bane.
No, I didn't like anything involving Bane, and I liked the actor who plays Bane, Tom Hardy.
Right.
He's normally very interesting, or at least somewhat interesting, depending on his role. He's certainly capable of being a terrific actor and screen presence, but he was just all covered up, and he had that bizarre kind of spidery contraption on his mouth, so you couldn't hear what he was saying.
It was like Yoda and Darth Vader combined.
I thought it was more Alec Guinness.
I really liked Bane as a villain, personally. I don't have...
You're wrong.
Of course I am. But I'm going to really... I would sit through Dark Knight Rises just for Anne Hathaway as the Catwoman.
Although
she is never called the Catwoman in the movie.
Right,
I thought the action was epic. I thought the movie was epic. I think at this point the audiences almost insisted on a little bit of ponderous because these movies take themselves very seriously.
Audiences never insist on ponderous.
Oh,
I'm
yes.
sorry. And I love The Dark Knight. I love The Dark Knight.
It was one of my fantastic.
Yes, absolutely. I love Christopher Nolan. Before this, I would have said I would enjoy anything that he makes.
Mm.
But the word you use, it was epic. I don't think a movie should try to be epic unless it really has the goods, and I didn't think it had the goods.
I'm going to say that I really felt that The Dark Knight Rises had the goods. Some of the best property damage you could have hoped for this year.
You love property damage.
Yeah, you do.
And as for, I like breaking big stuff in a movie. I don't like it so much in real life. In a movie, if it's big, I want it broken. I'm in the Godzilla school of let's knock it down.
I think Michael Caine deserves a supporting actor nomination. I thought he was powerful.
You didn't think
he
that
had
was
the
forced?
Best performance. No, he had the best performance.
I mean, I didn't.
I was with him in those couple of key scenes.
Yeah. I mean, I'm not saying he was forced. I just think that whole confrontation was forced.
Did I mention Anne Hathaway?
Yeah.
Who also I think is one of the best femme fatales I have seen in a movie in a long time. I think that's something Nolan really, really got was the resurgence of the dangerous 40s style femme fatale.
But did it go on a little too long? Yes. It's two hours and 45 minutes. It
a
was
little
just a
too,
tad
long.
Too
long. A little too long. A tad? That's more than
a
tad.
Go two
that's
and a half.
Major,
I'm okay with that.
That's a major tad.
Well,
that's
the typical tad. Running length of James Bond movies used to be 2 hours and 20 minutes.
Yeah, and they were too long. I'm sorry.
Well, you know, property damage takes time. It's like you can't rush a good pizza.
It can be strategic property damage. It doesn't have to be property damage that goes on and on and on and on.
But I didn't think it was extreme with The Dark Knight Rises at all. I didn't think the action scenes were epic, but I sort of liked the way it was.
I almost fell asleep. I'm sorry.
Can we get that portable defibrillator?
I got to go with the Avengers. I love the Avengers.
Yes.
I still do. One of the best of the summer, bringing all these superheroes together. It was so much fun, even from the opening scene.
Yeah, I loved it. It was a blast.
You've got three superhero movies lined up side by side. The Avengers is the lightest weight. Spider-Man's in the middle. Dark Knight is the darkest. I liked all three for what they were. In fact, all three offered good action, good property damage, and a different type of entertainment.
Yeah, I agree.
Disappointed by Spider-Man.
Oh, I really enjoyed Spider-Man.
I really did enjoy Spider-Man.
I was disappointed.
I saw it twice, and I enjoyed it both times. I really did.
There was really nothing to it.
I thought it was emotionally true. I mean, it's strange to say that about a comic book movie, but I found the characters made more sense in human terms than any of the previous incarnations, even with Toby.
I agree. I really thought that Mark Webb kind of completely supplanted the Sam Raimi versions. And I also thought, as Spider-Man is in fact the first superhero movie, big superhero movie that was actually shot in 3D.
Yeah.
Because all the other Marvel ones have all been post-converted.
Correct.
I thought it was very interesting to see what an indie director did using 3D, and although he had the sense to throw debris at the camera and the lizard's tail at the camera and things like that,
but
I think
the
he knew
it wasn't a surprise. It really wasn't.
Well, Sam Raimi teased us about the lizard for 3 movies and never delivered. So we finally got the lizard.
That's true.
But here are these 20-year-old actors, 28, 23, and they're playing 17-year-olds.
Have you not seen One Tree Hill?
That was unbelievable. Suspension of belief.
I mean, quite frankly, compared to what the CW has been pulling for years with middle-aged teenagers, I really thought that Andrew Garfield and Emma Stone passed as teenagers at least as well as Chad Michael Murray, who I think was about 42 when he started One Tree Hill. So,
but what about the Dennis Leary table scene? That was uncomfortable.
I love Dennis Leary anyway. And I Andrew Garfield is an actor that I've had my eye on for years. And I thought he was terrific. And I thought he brought a combination of vulnerability and real believability in his sourpuss scenes. I mean, he's very believable angry teenager.
And if we're talking about action, which theoretically we are in this segment, one thing you've got with this Spider-Man, which you did not have in the previous Spider-Man movies, is that they were actually doing a lot of the stunt work practical on location. They weren't doing CGI from the soup course right through to dessert.
Yeah.
I mean, this was a this gave us action that looked a lot more real. Mm-hmm. And again, they were shooting it on the new Red Epic cameras, which now every big name, ever since Peter Jackson announced.
It looked good. And the property damage was sufficient. Like, this is an example of an action movie that didn't go completely overboard with the property damage. There's enough property damage in that movie.
Right.
And that movie is not 2 hours and 40 minutes long.
Right.
So you don't need to have a 2 hour and 40 minute running time for sufficient property damage.
One movie that surprised me was Snow White and the Huntsman. I thought it had enough great twists in it to keep it engaging and enjoyable, and Charlize Theron was fantastic as the Evil Queen.
Are you a fan of hers?
I was for that movie. I really like that, and I gotta go with the Expendables 2 as well. A fantastic opening sequence that's just fun, and another great action scene toward the end as well. So those are my favorite action films of the summer. So are you a fan of Charlize Theron? Or?
Generally I am, yeah. It depends on the role. But my two favorites this summer were The Avengers and Spider-Man.
Okay.
And I also really liked Men in Black 3. I thought it was enjoyable.
Yeah.
I wouldn't have considered it the best action movie of the summer. I liked the movie a lot, and I'll find a way to talk about it in one of the other segments.
I think it's more action than comedy, but Josh Brolin was fantastic as the younger K. All right, those are our favorite action movies of the summer.